common conversation among comic book fans is that of speculating about which directors we'd most like to see direct a comic book movie. And while many big name directors get thrown around, there's one name that gets mentioned the most, and that is Quentin Tarantino. So what if I told you that he almost directed a comic book movie not once, but three times throughout his career? The first one of these such instances was around 1992, right after he released Reservoir Dogs. In an interview he made for the Nerdist podcast in 2015, he described how as a kid, he would love to imagine how the comics he was reading would play out as a movie. He even named some of his favorite comics as a kid, like Werewolf by Night, Shang-Chi, Master of Kung Fu, Morbius the Living Vampire, Tomb of Dracula, and the title that he considered making into a movie, Luke Cage, Hero for Hire. He described Luke Cage as his favorite hero as a kid, and the comic that he most collected. And as far as why he opted to not make the movie in the end, he had this to say during the podcast.
The thing is, in the case of Luke Cage, it was my comic geek friends that almost talked me out of it. Because I thought Larry Fishburne back in the day would have been a great Luke Cage. And they were talking about Wesley Snipes. And I could see them both. But it was like, oh, but, you know, I think Fish would be better. And they go, yeah, but I mean, you know, look, he could work out and everything, but he doesn't have the bod, you know, that Wesley Snipes has. And Luke Cage needs to have the bod. And I literally was so turned off that would be their both starting and ending point.
Right.
You know, that it literally put it, I don't know if I'm ever going to do it, but it literally put it in my head that if I do a comic book movie, it should be an original character.
Ultimately, though, he felt he made the right decision to not make the movie in the end, since he ended up making Pulp Fiction instead. He also made some comments regarding the character's Netflix show a few months before it had come out, saying that he would have preferred if they made the blaxploitation elements of the character's mythos more prevalent and focused more on nailing that presentation and aesthetic, something that the Netflix show didn't really do all that well when it came out. Still though, this wasn't the last time Tarantino pondered the possibility of directing a comic book movie. During the late 90s, 20th Century Fox had bought the movie rights to Iron Man and were actively trying to make the film happen. Nicolas Cage and Tom Cruise had even expressed interest in playing the character. The studio later approached Tarantino to see if he'd be interested in writing and directing the project, but in the end it went nowhere. And finally, he not only almost got to adapt a couple of Marvel characters, but also a character from DC Comics, and that is Sergeant Rock in the Easy Company, characters who fought in World War II in the DC Universe. In 2008, he revealed in an interview that he had been considering directing a script by David Webb Peoples, who wrote the scripts for Unforgiven and Blade Runner, saying that he wrote a movie version of Sergeant Rock that I always thought was really terrific. I don't think I'm ever going to end up doing it, but I really did like that script, and it's one of the few times I've considered doing another writer's script. So there you have it, three instances in which we could have gotten to see a comic book movie by one of Hollywood's most popular directors currently. Even though we didn't get to see Sergeant Rock or Luke Cage, we did get to see Tarantino explore a war setting and themes in Inglourious Basterds, and we got to see him indulge in blaxploitation during Django Unchained. So me personally, I'm more curious about the idea of an Iron Man movie directed by Tarantino. It would be very interesting to see a straight superhero movie in Tarantino style. So with that, I finished this video with a question for you. What comic book character have you always thought would fit Tarantino's directing style for a movie adaptation? Me personally, I always thought DC's Hitman would be a very fitting character for Tarantino. Comment below your character. And as always, thanks for watching.